Being a medical doctor is one thing and being a triathlete is another. Our remarkable woman this morning does it both. We're glad to be joined in today by Dr. Lillian Grace or Ian Banzon, triathlete slash medical and sports acupuncture physician. Hi, Doc Ian. Good morning. And of course, welcome to Early Edition as we celebrate Women's Month, and you are our remarkable woman for this morning. But you know, we backtrack through everything to what you're doing now, mm-hmm. being a medical doctor as a triathlete. You actually started your roots as part of the swimming team,
mm-hmm. yeah,
for the Ateneo. So how was that like, and what was your maybe interest and exposure to sports that made you on what you are today?
Well, first of all, good morning too. I started swimming in grade school. It just started off as one of those summer things that you do, and then eventually I just never stopped and became competitive with it, even during school. And then from then on, everything just kind of trickled down. Like, I was lucky enough to have a coach that exposed us to other sports during off season as well. So we would know how to do running, badminton, and all kinds of other stuff. And then eventually I just carried it on, like building that habit of having sports and exercise and academics all until med school and even up to now.
You actually strive for excellence, three-time captain for UAP yeah. swimming team, and eventually you also transitioned to water polo, being part of the Philippine team for the SEA Games in 2015. So
yeah,
how was
Singapore.
That like in Singapore? But how was that like during your younger years that mm-hmm. you had to maintain a certain level of excellence?
Well, you know, if everyone's doing it, like my teammates, we're all just training, it doesn't seem as hard. Well, for me at least, when you have someone that is doing it with you and it seems like it's a normal thing to do. Like all of my teammates, you were all studying and also doing training. With water polo, I got exposed, as I said, our coach exposed us to different sports. So he was a national water polo team member when he was younger. So sometimes we would do water polo and he'd actually bring us to the national training pool in Rizal. And not a lot of girls there too, but mm-hmm. we just all join in as well. And then eventually I learned to love the sport and other sports as well. And then I developed the habit of just of having that balance. And then without noticing it, it just kind of all patong-patong lang. It all built up together. And before you know it, I was in med school doing sports. I was training with the national team for water polo since I was second year med school. Although I did it in high school already, just in and out.
But you knew you wanted to pursue med way before.
I'm a very curious person, so I have a special interest in science. So it was really one of the things that I really considered. And I really wanted to learn about the body, how it works, and maybe how to help people get better.
Mm-hmm. Now, as an acupuncture physician, do these things that you do in life complement each other, and how does it all help?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, if you're concerned about health, and I know health is a very big issue right now, exercise and having an active lifestyle is a big part of that. Of course, there's nutrition, there's rest and sleep, but also physical activity. I mean, if you don't have enough, then your body wouldn't be in an optimal position as well. It's all a balance of everything. So I'm the type of person that kind of leads by example. So it's nice when I tell my patients that this is what you're supposed to do. I can honestly say that's what I do as well. And I mean, I'm not perfect. You know, we all slip down sometimes, but getting back on track. And it's easier and believable for patients when they see their doctor or someone who's telling them what to do actually does what they do. So I think it all kind of ties in.
Well, you mentioned that not everybody is perfect, and sometimes you fall and slip. And mm-hmm. that what makes, you know, a perfect story. You know,
I have a lot of those.
I mean, lots of challenges, lots of pain, struggle, personal struggles. What have been those personally mm-hmm. that you had to go through?
Let's start with physical. I've had a lot of injuries. I tore my ACL twice, both knees. So I've had a couple of surgeries from sports, even like dental sports accidents. Recovering from injuries is really something that is mentally taxing. But you, on hindsight, you learn a lot. I think being a patient has helped me become a better doctor because you understand the situation that your patients are in. Also, there's a lot of learnings. I mean, if you don't fail, you don't know what you're doing wrong. So it's a good checker for you to keep on being a little bit better. It highlights the things you need to work on. On other notes, I have other challenges that I faced as well. Like when I was in med school before, because we have the board exams at the end. So that was 2015. That was the same year I did Southeast Asian Games. Same year I was studying for the board exams. Also because I coach at Nike Run Club. So that was also the time I was training for it. And all those things happened before the board exams. So that was kind of hard as well mentally, but I think being in sports and being accustomed to high pressure situations has helped me get through it. And I still, because SEA Games was June, training in the US for a run club was July, and then August was board exams.
Wow.
So it was just like, one thing after the other.
Well, of course, you had to pick the board exams, right?
Yeah, I did all, but I kind of calculated it as well.
Doc, was there ever a time that you felt the need to prove yourself? Was there ever a time that you felt so down that I had to go through adversity?
Always. I mean, you don't see it. Sometimes people just see all the good things. And it's harder to post about your struggles. I think a lot of people can relate to that. And it's easier just to pose when you're happy and when you're winning. So sometimes that's just what people see. They just see that you're doing well, you're doing good. But you know, it takes a lot of work, hard work, effort, blood, sweat, and tears to make things look easy. They just look easy, but getting there really a lot, takes a lot.
And at the same time, Doc Ayan, when we are down, when we want to pull ourselves back up, did you ever feel a time that you had to earn that respect? Maybe in your field as a triathlete, you also compete in CrossFit events, and at the same time in your profession. How was that like?
Well, you can't avoid those moments. I think the support of people around you helps a lot too. And having the proper mindset of just trying to stay positive and seeing the light at the end of the tunnel. I mean, sometimes you're so deep that you can't see it anymore, but you know, it's bound to get better. And personally for me, when I'm at that stage, one of the things I think about is that, you know, nowhere to go but up. And I also take comfort in the fact that I know other people have been through struggles as well. And if they can get through that, then I know I can kind of get through it as well, because I'm not the first person to be going through that, and I won't be the last. And I just needed to just see it through.
As an influential person, as an influential woman in your field, in the world of medicine and in sports, how do you inspire and how do you get inspired by other people as well?
As I said, I'm a kind of lead by example kind of person. So I just try to do what I have to do and just try to be a good role model. Try to do the things the right way as much as I can. Help a lot more people and contribute as much as I can to help people get better. And eventually, I don't want to hard sell it. If they see it, then hopefully they just get inspired by it. And if they get to talk to me, hopefully they pick something up that can help them as well.
Well, also as a doctor and as a coach and as an athlete as well. Lastly, Doc Ayan, for you, what is a remarkable woman?
Okay, for me, it's someone, I want to say a remarkable person, not just a woman. If you want to be someone remarkable, it's going beyond yourself and trying to strive for something that's better, not necessarily one big leap. It can be little steps at a time, and it is a constant progress. You just keep on improving and getting better.
All right, so there you have it, Doc Ayan Banzon. Thank you so much for joining us here this
morning. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.